Now we are discussing the algorithm for deleting element from the two-way list. We know that the two-way list traverses in two directions. One is the forward and one is the backward. So we are starting the algorithm here. And in this algorithm, we have mentioned del for delete two-way list. Now, whenever we are inserting or deleting a node, we need a list which is called avail list. Avail list is the list of free memories. So first of all, I am taking the avail list. So now we are having the three nodes here, node 1, node 2, and node 3. Every node of the linked list, which is a two-way list, contain the three parts. One is the info part. Info part contain the information. And the second part we are having is the forward part, which is called FORW. And the forward part contain the address of the next node. So here the forward is containing the address of node 2. Now talking about the forward part of node 2, that contain the address of node 3. And node 3 forward part, there is nothing afterward. That's why it is pointing to the null. Null means there is no further values available. And yes, this is the avail list. So here there is avail pointer, which will be pointing to the first node. So that is the two-way list of the available type. Now there is one more pointer, which is the backward pointer. So this one is the backward pointer, which can point to the backward. But in the available list, the backward pointer is having the no meaning. Because if we talk about the available list cannot be the header list. Available list cannot be the two-way list. Available list only work in the one direction. That's why we have taken another forward. We have taken three nodes here. And in the nodes, we have taken the three further parts. That is implying that we are working on the two-way list. But that doesn't mean that available list will be working with the backward pointer also. No. Available list only work in the one direction. Now, this is the available list of the free memories available. So we have three memories available on which we can perform the operation of the insertion or the deletion. Now, we are creating our own list on which we are applying the operation. So I am taking the nodes there. So there we are having the three nodes which we have taken of our own list. Let us suppose that N1, N2 and N3, these are the three nodes. And now we know that every node is having the info part. So node number 1 is having the info part, which contain the information. Node 2 also have the info part, and node 3 also have the info part. Now this is our own list. So we are storing some elements. Let us suppose that here we are storing 7, then 3 and 9. So these are elements we have stored there. Now afterward we are having the forward pointer. So one part of node is having the forward pointer. This forward pointer will be pointing to the address of next node. So talking about the forward pointer of node 2, that is pointing to the next node address, which is the node 3 address. Now we are having one more forward pointer, and that will be pointing to the null, because afterward there is nothing. Now if you talk about the start, so here we are having a start. So start will be pointing to the first node. So here it is pointing to the address of the first node. Now afterward we are having one more pointer, which is the backward pointer. So here we are having the backward pointer in the node 3. And node 3 backward pointer will be pointing to the node 2 address. Then node 2 backward pointer, that will be pointing to the address of node 1. Similarly, node 1 backward pointer, that will be pointing to the null, because there is nothing behind that. This is the two-way list, because you can see that it can traverse in the forward direction as well as in the backward direction. So now we can work with the algorithm. Now here we have the info part, which contains the information, forwarding, then backwarding, start, which is pointing to the first node, avail. Avail is the available list, which is having the free nodes. Then the loc. Loc is the location. There we want to delete an element. So you can see that loc is the location of node, which will be deleted from the two-way list. So we are taking a location here. Let us suppose that the node 2 is the location. So this is the location where we want to delete element. That means we don't want this node 2 here. This node 2 should be removed from the two-way list. Now we are going with the algorithm. The first line says that set forward backward location. That is interesting. Now first of all, we should go with the inner bracket. Then afterward, we should understand location. So where the location is? The location is on the node 2. Now backward, location to backward, going towards from location to the backward. Now this one is the backward, location backward here. This is pointing where? It is pointing to the previous node. That means now we are on the node 1. Afterward we are having the forward. That means node 1 forward part. So we are talking about this particular part. This pointer we are talking about is equal to forward loc. Now to understand this location, so location is on the node 2 forward part. Where that forward is pointing? The forward is pointing to the node 3. That means we are talking about the node 3. So here the complete sentence says that the node 1 forward will be attached with the node 3 address. So that is what this particular line is saying. So that is interesting. Now afterward we are having the another line which is saying that backward forward loc is equal to backward loc. Now to understand this, we will see here. Now here we are understanding from inner to outer location. So where the location is pointing? The location is on the node 2. That means we are on the node 2 forward part. So node 2 forward part means this one. So we are talking about the forward. So forward is this one. Now this is the forward part. Then backward. So where the forward is pointing? This forward is pointing here on node 3. That means we are on the node 3, and the backward part means we are talking about this particular pointer. Then we are saying loc means the location, and we know that the location is on the node 2, and here backward. So here you see the backward. Where the backward is pointing? The backward is pointing to the node 1. That means talking about node 1. So this particular pointer of node 3 is now attached with the node 1 address. So that is interesting. You can see that it is like a bridge. The forward pointer is having the bridge and the backward pointer is having the bridge. So here we can see that if we talk about the node 1, in the node 1 forward part is now having a bridge which is directly jumping to the node 3, and node 3 backward part is having the bridge which is directly jumping to the node 1. That means node 2 is now not into the picture. This is the time to give the node 2 back to the available list, because we are deleting this and it will be available for other people. Now we are going to the next line. Here we are having set forward of loc. So first of all, we are going in location. We know that the location is the node 2. So node 2 forward part. Node 2 forward part means this one we are talking about, means this particular pointer we are talking about, this forward pointer, is equal to avail. So this pointer is now attached to the avail. You can see that an avail is pointing to the node 1. That means node 2 is now preceding the node 1. Afterward we are having the next thing, which is available is equal to loc. So available is equal to loc means this available pointer is now moved here and it is pointing to the location. We know that where the location is. This one is the location where we should reach. So this particular is now moving to the location. So now this node is captured. So you can see that successfully this node is the part of the available list. And we know that the available list only work in the one direction. It is a one-way list. That's why the backward pointer of this node is having no meaning. So successfully, this location is now the part of the available list. So if we are going to see the available list, you can see that this node is now taken care by the available list. Now if you are going to traverse the list, which is our own list, we will start here. And with the start, we are going with the 7. So 7 will be displayed. And afterward, we are going further. And you can see that there is a bridge which is crossing the node which we have deleted. And then we are having 9. So 9 is displayed. Then afterward, we are going forward and null. Null means end. So there we can also traverse in the backward direction also, because this is a two-way list, but I have traversed in one direction. So 7 and 9 are successfully displayed here. So this is how we can delete a node into the two-way list.